The Philippine Competition Commission is back in business with a resumption of regular merger review operations last week. Joining us now, Competition Czar Arsenio Balisacan. Hi, sir. Good morning. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning, Michelle. Good morning, everyone.
Okay, so how has the pandemic changed your role as competition becomes less of an issue and companies really hunker down to just survival mode?
Well, Michelle, let me clarify. No? Competition is now more important, more critical than ever because many companies, particularly small and medium enterprises, are likely hit hard and they're likely very vulnerable to mergers and acquisitions. And we have to make sure that the level playing field is maintained while we are in a state of calamity, of pandemic, to make sure also that the welfare losses suffered by our population are not exacerbated by anti-competitive practices. So we are pretty busy in monitoring the markets, and we want to contribute in ensuring that the market is or will remain competitive, and it's also very conducive for the revival of the economy.
Mm-hmm. Now, we talk a lot about consolidation, as you mentioned, these days, you know, when parties, smaller players join forces and balance sheets to combat this crisis, or with the exit of companies that crumble under the weight of the recession. Sir, how does your pipeline look like today? Has anybody filed for these?
We actually have a number of pending cases. That's why we have to now resume our merger review along with the other agencies to make sure that we respond to this request for a review of their mergers and notifications. Yeah, we have many of them, and we expect to be getting a lot of applications, notifications for review in the coming weeks.
Mm-hmm. Chairman, can you give us an idea how many exactly we're talking about, and if these companies are exclusively filing because of the COVID pandemic?
Well, at the moment, we have about 10 pending in our for our review. They are now they have gone through the sufficiency stage already, and but we expect that as the public knows that we are now open for business, especially in the actual review, we expect that these filings would accelerate.
These 10 pending filings that you have, Chairman Balisacan, these are for mergers and acquisitions?
Correct, yeah. This, remember that mergers and review processes were suspended by executive issuances along with those that in other agencies.
And from what industries do these companies come from?
Well, they come from various sectors, manufacturing, services, banks, a lot of the, this spread across industries.
Mm-hmm. Chairman, here's another scenario, though it didn't crumble under the weight of the pandemic, but a rejected franchise application. Do you think the shutdown of ABS-CBN, one of two media giants, is anti-competitive? Because ABS-CBN has a market share of 30 to 44% off-air. That share will gravitate towards competition. And in other jurisdiction, any increase of market share of at least 10% already raises a red flag. Are you seeing competition concerns with the shutdown of Channel 2?
Well, the practice in most jurisdictions, and also in our practice, is that as the evidence shows that it's not enough to be big. I think what's even more important is that the increase in market shares is associated with increase in ability and incentive to abuse market power or to exercise market power. And so that's where we come in. We are watching the market to make sure that as the market consolidates, if it consolidates at all, we need to ensure that we are there to review the situation and plug necessary concerns. Mm-hmm. just to be sure, no, Michelle, we gave our comment, our position to this issue to Congress when it was deliberating whether to renew or not renew the franchise, and mm-hmm. we gave scenarios there and what would likely happen, including the fear that market might become more or less competitive. And of course, the situation now is yes, the franchise was not renewed, so we need to watch what will happen next. If it's going to be purchased by a current player, then obviously that has to be examined carefully, and we'll watch that development carefully. But if it's going to be, the assets are going to be purchased by another party who has a otherwise interest in other the same business or market, then that is probably a less concern from the point of view of competition. Mm-hmm. So that's what where we are. We are watching what will happen next.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But even without the plans of any other group to purchase the properties or assets of ABS-CBN, the mere fact that you're closing the country's biggest television network, does that not raise any alarm bells? Is that not serious anti-competitive?
We always say, Michelle, bigness is not necessarily an issue. It's not prohibited by our law. What is prohibited is the exercise of market power or the abuse of market power associated with that bigness. So once there is evidence, there is a compelling reason that entity is now exercising its market power to the extent that its services are becoming more expensive, quality is getting poorer, and so on. Mm-hmm. Then we could come in.
Mm-hmm. Chairman, what about the perception that there may be too much government intervention in industries? Isn't that anti-competitive as well?
Well,
and quite frankly, a turnoff to foreign investors or to even local investors.
We understand that the sector has other regulators, mm-hmm. The NTC, the SEC, and they all have different functions. And for us, we don't question the mandate of the sector regulator. Mm-hmm. What we watch for and is whether the instrument to achieve their objective, their mandate, is anti-competitive, and that's we have also in our law the mandate to advise government and government agencies for any anti-competitive mm-hmm. practices that might go with the practice mm-hmm. or a regulation or policy coming from other government agency.
Mm-hmm. Chairman, let's now move on to other issues. The Philippine Competition Commission has raised red flags against the creation of a state-backed holding company that's going to be run by Land Bank and DBP that's supposed to help ailing businesses by infusing equity and granting various perks from taxes, exemptions from the Procurement Act for 3 years, the GOCC Act, and the Philippine Competition Act for 3 years. What do you think will make that initiative more acceptable from the competitive side?
Yes, we have given our position papers to both houses of Congress, Michelle, and mm-hmm. some of the proposals that have those features. And we flag concerns. We are not saying that the commission is against the proposals. I think the objectives are commendable because they intend to keep jobs and revive the economy as fast as we can. And that's everybody's, I think, interest, including the PCC. What we point out, though, is that we should be watchful for the risk associated with certain instruments, mm-hmm. choice of instruments. I mean, the competition risk and and we flag alternative or pro-competitive remedies or solutions to address the concerns.
Okay. Final question, Chairman. Looking ahead, what's the outlook for M&A deals this year? Given the volatility in the markets, we can imagine how much tougher it is to price deals. We know that in 2019, M&A deals doubled to 812 billion pesos. Are you going to hit that number again this year, or perhaps even more?
As the rest of the economy is exposed a lot of uncertainty, as the rest of the economies in the world, Michelle, it's really hard to say what will happen and how the risk and uncertainty evolves in the coming months. But all we see at this point is that surely the pandemic has caused so much pain and so much it's likely going to cause a lot of restructuring across the firms and industries. And I think there will be a lot of those mergers and acquisitions, particularly acquisitions, that we will see in the coming months.
Okay, and you're going to be very, very busy, sir. Thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Thank you very much, Michelle.